So, you know, the transition to boxing, the lifestyle was similar. I had to, you know, obviously change a lot of things. But I've been, you know, I've been fighting professionally without a headgear since I was 19 years old. So, you know, just having that experience where, you know, fighting professionally. My pro debut in kickboxing, I was 19. I fought a 36-year-old man. You know, so having that experience of fighting at a young age in a dangerous sport.
Do you think it gives you any advantages over someone who's just done boxing, for example?
Do you think it gives you?
Oh, in terms of like sport and technique, I don't really think so. They really are two different sports. There are similar techniques in one or the other, but removing. Just the experience quality of it, I don't think technically it's any advantage.
But what kickboxing does do, you know you're going to get hurt in kickboxing, don't you? Because, because you are going to take kicks,
yeah.
And it prepares you mentally for a tougher fight.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever walked out of a kickbox fight and limped out of every single one of them, because my shins and toes and ankles and my elbows, kicks hurt a lot.
It's hurting them before they hurt you in kickboxing.
Yeah, kickboxing is rough. It's a very, very rough sport. Like you said, even when you win, you're hurt.
You only need to look at one of the glory events, for example.
They're brutal.
What it's all about.
Brutal.
Keith has talked a lot about how mentally tough you are, but in this setting, have you been at all taken aback by how hard Freddie Roach has tried to get in your head?
Did I laugh answer that? It's, I don't know, I guess either it's gamesmanship on his part, or he really is, you know, ticked off by me. I'm not really sure. But I'm sticking to what I'm saying. I'm not fighting Freddie Roach, and it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I'm fighting his guy. I'm not gonna get dragged into an argument or a Twitter battle or anything like that with people. That's just not my style.
What about when Manny says he's a kid, and you know he'll learn what it feels like to lose, in so many words, not exactly, but
that's what he's supposed to say. That's what he's supposed to say. I'm where he was 15 years ago. You know, so that's just the nature of the sport. He has a tremendous amount of experience, a lot more than I do. And he's been here in these world stages many, many times, and this is my first time. But it was his first time once before, too, so we all start somewhere.
Forgive me for arriving late, but have you talked about reach and length at all in this conversation? Obviously, that's a huge advantage for you in this fight. And could it be the key to what happens on Sunday morning?
It's, you know, it's been brought up a lot. It's been brought up more by their camp than my camp. Height and reach is not going to be the difference in this fight. That's not going to be what's going to win the fight. It's going to be my preparation and my mental attitude and just, you know, me sticking to the game plan. Is it a factor? Sure, but it's a factor in every one of my fights. I'm a 5'11", 140 pounder, so I'm taller than almost everybody that I fight. I've got a 72-inch reach, you know, and from my way. It's great to see them and interact with them. Maidana, I was in a training camp with him for three of his camps. You know, did a lot of sparring with him. Great guy, you know, really, really good guy. I've been in contact with Sergio Martinez, you know, leading up to this fight.
Do you have advice for you?
He just wishing me luck and just, all positive stuff, good stuff. He said that he's, we're on the same team, you know, kind of thing. Another great guy. But, we've got reached out. Who else? Jorge Barrios, he reached out from Argentina. He was like, "You're Argentinian?" I was like, "Yeah." And then we kind of went back and forth on Twitter about that. But, it's cool to have, these guys reach out now and so many of the Argentine fans.
And obviously it's a fight and it's part of your professional athletic career, but have you allowed yourself to think historically what a victory in this event could mean for you on Saturday, on Sunday morning?
Not too much. I'm really taking one foot in front of the other. I'm not thinking too much beyond.
because you're fighting a guy who, there are two guys they've talked about in this generation around this weight, and a victory for you unbeaten against one of these guys could mean you fight the other one.
Trust me, I grasp the magnitude of the situation, but I haven't given too much thought on to what any of that would mean. I haven't really gotten past the point of just getting my hands raised, you know. So that's as far as my my future forethought is thinking, you know.
Brilliant.
Pacquiao's got this 300 strong entourage. Now, what do you make of that? And you won the title for how big you are?
No, my entourage should be the same.
Yeah,
I've got my entourage is very, very tight. It's basically my team and my family. That's it. We're here now. I don't foresee really bringing anybody else on. My team and my entourage grew after the Ruslan fight, but it grew in terms of kind of employees. So, you know, my accountant, my attorney, financial advisor, advisor, manager, this type stuff. My new cut man. But other than that, you know, it's this is kind of a bare bones operation. Like, we only keep it lean.
Why'd you pick something more from a camp with 300 people sitting around?
Maybe they're lonely. I don't know. I'm a loner anyway, so I'm fine in my, even at my suite here. I mean, like, oh, you know, one of my trainers wanted to stay with me. I'm like, I'm okay. I'm okay in my big suite. Like my own space, my own time.
Chris, do you think it's a little bit disrespectful that they're already saying that Mayweather versus Pacquiao or Jesse Vargas is next for Pacquiao?
I don't take it as that. They said the same thing before the Ruslan-Kovalnikov fight about him fighting Manny Pacquiao, and I said after I beat Ruslan, he can fight Pacquiao if he wants, you know, or that's what happens. And look what happened, so I'm not concerned about that kind of stuff. Those are those things, if you notice, a lot of things that if they don't really matter, I don't think about them. You know, you can't let those things cloud your mind or slow you down.